this place because we hope the place is open. It's been given up in relation to that.
Just to say, if you are, don't spend a bit in your day boring and talking. Keep an eye on this sun. He's going to play to look around at the sun rather than at me. But just to make the point that we're standing in front of us by the Western Tomb. As you know, Knockroe is a real outlier. The tombs that like this are mainly to be found in the Boyne Valley. And if not in the Boyne Valley, in other parts of County Meath, this is unusual because it has all the features of the tombs in the Boyne Valley. And indeed, if this were found in the Boyne Valley after the three big tombs, Newgate, Nels and Down, this would be the most spectacular of the rest of the tombs that were in the Boyne Valley. So it is not perfect, it's not perfect stations. But it's down here in a long way away from the Boyne Valley. There is one of the few passages in the current region. There's another one over on top, that green hill over there, Wall Green. A few more over the Glen Bardo, or overlooking the Glen Bardo. But generally, they're not that funny, and they're connected with Sweden Wall. There's a cairn and cottages in them as well. But this one, light out, which is what makes it really interesting in some ways. Now it overlooks the River Boyne, which flows from the west, turns sharply south just below the site of now and heads off down to the elite or there. That's exactly what the Ling Town River does here as well. And just like now, this has an eastern tomb and a western tomb. But this has one very special feature about it, that it's the only site I know of in Europe, anywhere, that in the morning the rising sun is rising off to the eastern tomb or the southern tomb facing southeast, and the setting sun is setting opposite the western tomb here. And it's the most expected place. It's quite possible that stone also is probably an icon as well in their minds, you know. We have a different situation. Okay, they did go out of their way to find stones that have special qualities like quartz veins in them or other sorts of special parts, like unusual shapes or something like that, which we often place in special places. Also, it's worth pointing out that we know there are over 30 decorated stones on the site, but in fact, there are probably more. If you're ever down here on your own,
just gently walk around if the sun is shining, just keep your eye off and you might find some negative gas. So for example, we thought we had it on, but not to try, but it's just in case you might have an accident. We thought we had it all, and then one day the sun here, we're working here. Was the sun just really shining into the dead, not to the living, you know? Or did you have to stay away from here on that day? What did it mean? It was important, you know? I think the idea, as I said before, the idea that the sun was a god and they were worshipping the sun is probably a little bit going, being a bit simplistic, because they were more subtle than that. It's probably that it stood for what they believed. You know, it's a symbol rather than being the object in its own right, so to speak. But it does tell us how they understood the world. Okay? And of course, they picked this beautiful valley. All right? And they must have been wonderful people, because so are their successors. Okay. Thanks very much. That's